Hi everyone, I crocheted this spacious beach bag a while ago, but never shared the crochet process. It's very simple, made with single crochet stitches. What makes this bag unique for me is the combination of different materials. The bag itself is crocheted from raffia, while the edges and handles are made from waxed cord. I adore this bag and use it constantly, not just at the beach. It's always with me when I need to carry various things for my kids. I took a photo of the bag when I had just finished crocheting it completely. In the video where I'm wearing it, you can see the condition it's in after prolonged use. Of course, raffia is not the most durable material, and you naturally can't carry heavy items with it. But usually, I can comfortably fit everything I need in the bag. The loops have stretched a bit, but overall the bag hasn't changed much. And if you make a lining to the bag, it will add extra strength to it. I didn't make a lining. If you'd like to make one for yourself, the process is straightforward but not very quick, so it's a perfect time to put on your favorite audiobook or series, brew a cup of tea, and enjoy the peaceful art of crocheting. So let me tell you about the process. I spent about 2.5 skeins of raffia and half a skein of waxed cord for this bag. And for the raffia, I used a 3.5 mm crochet hook, and for the waxed cord, I used a 4 mm crochet hook. The bag is made using only single crochet stitches. How to make chain stitches with a hook and crochet single crochets is demonstrated in the video on a small sample. I crocheted three parts, one large main panel and two side panels. For the main panel, I made 67 chain stitches. The main panel requires 100 rows. And for each side panel, I made 21 chain stitches and crocheted 40 rows. After that, the pieces need to be steamed and dried completely. Next, start edging each piece with single crochet stitches around the perimeter. I put right side up and begin making edging. I took 4mm hook and at the end finish with a full stitch. After finishing edging, I seamed the pieces again. The next step is to join the pieces. I left a 3-4 meter tail after edging one side panel and the main panel. I will use this tail to connect the pieces and finish the backstop. To join the pieces, I took a large eyed needle and marked 40 stitches for the side panels and 20 stitches for the bottom panel, and mark these stitches with marker to avoid mistakes. I sewed the pieces together, making sure to keep the stitches voluminous. Here in the video, I'll pull the thread strongly, then I changed my mind and sewed not so tight, with giving the stitches a little volume. It seemed to me that it was so much more beautiful. This is what the seam will look like if you do not pull the thread too hard. Now it's time to make the handles. To make the handles, I will work with the edge of the side panel. I will count 15 stitches from the edge and insert the hook in the 15th stitch and make a chain stitch. I am crocheting 3 single crochet stitches into the next 3 stitches. Then one turning stitch and turn the work. I hide the tail of the thread in several rows for higher strength. For each handle, I crocheted 65 rows of single crochet stitches and attached them symmetrically to the back. Finish step is wrapping the top loops with a needle, and in the end I will hide all the tails under the loops that are crocheted with a waxed cord, since they are more rigid and hold the threads well. That's it. It needs to seam it last time, and the beach bag is ready to use. I'm wrapping up the video now. I hope you enjoyed this pack. Wish you a pleasant viewing and see you soon.